Hey guys, today I'm going to be working on this little LCT big bore build, and I've got to weigh some of this stuff up. Now I'm not going to show this on part two, so I thought I would make a short video for you guys that's following along with this build and maybe a similar build. And what I'm going to do today is trying to weigh up some parts here and try to maintain the balance. Now these pins, this is the one out of the LCT, the 65 millimeter bore, and this is the one out of the Wildcat flat top piston. Now both of these wrist pins are around 709 thousandths, and this is the one out of the LCT. Now notice this LCT wrist pin is shorter. It's shorter, but it's also thicker. So let's see what we come up with here. Looks like the LCT pin weighs 46.4 grams and the Wildcat pin is 41.4. So that's going to be in our favor. Good. And I've left the rings on this LCT piston and also left the rings on the Wildcat piston. I'm going to try to weigh as much of this stuff together as I can. And you can see it says 65 on right on the middle of the piston. So this is the one out of the LCT. And it comes in at 149.3 grams. And I'm going to have all the math and the numbers down in the description, guys. The Wildcat piston. It's got rings and one wrist pin retainer just like the LCT piston. Comes in at 152.7. Well, that's not much more. That's not much more. Yeah, that's not much more weight than the LCT piston. Big difference on the bore, but not much weight on that piston. And that's another reason I like those Wildcat pistons. Much lighter. All right, the LCT pin and piston combo is 195.7 grams. Let's see what the Wildcat piston and wrist pin combo, well, they weigh together. 194.1. So, hey, you know, that's pretty close. I'm liking this. Now, this is the Mars rod that came in the LCT engine. These are pretty good rods. A little bit darker color. But a lot of guys like them, you know. It's just a stock rod as far as I'm concerned. And that weighs in at 141.9 grams. And remember, guys, I will put all these findings and the numbers, weights and stuff down in the description. And this is the 8281. This is an EC. It's a forged billet rod. And it's 3 inches, 353,000. Now that's that long rod. You know, you guys know I like this long one. And it comes in at 125. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, we got to add the bearing. 147.1. Now, some guys don't weigh the bearing, but I think, you know, you got to count everything on the end of that crank throw, on that rod throw. So it all adds up. And now I'm going to try to see if I can't assemble this just for a mock assembly. I'm going to put this EC long billet rod on this Wildcat piston. And I'm going to check some fitment and check, see what the deck looks like. When we can get this down in the block, get these rings off here real quick. I won't need those on there. No need in compressing them and uncompressing them just to check some fits. And you guys know how this goes. You know, you just, when you're checking for clearances and fitting parts, you know, you'll go together, then come apart several times before you get satisfied with your combo. At least I do, anyway. But another good thing about these Wildcat pistons, they do come with the lower tension ring, and you can actually fit the top ring. That's a little bit larger than like about a 10 over ring. So you can fit it to your standard bore perfectly. whatever you choose to do, you know. And I've got to get a bearing half in here. And, you know, like I was saying before, guys, when the some of these guys, when they weigh their rod, you know, they'll leave that bearing out. They consider that as part of the crankshaft weight. But, you know, to me, it's anything that's on the rod throw side that's added on to the crank, yeah, you need to consider that weight. And that's just the way I do it. You know, if you do it yours differently, that's fine. You know, I'm just not here to fault anybody. I'm just showing you the way I do it. I'm going to get this bearing centered here. And if you don't push that tab all the way over, that oil hole won't be centered. Arrow down. Get the rod installed on there temporarily. And got a good fit on that bore. Situated on the crankshaft here. Now, I really do like this combo, but, you know, this is the first LCT block I've built, so I don't have any idea where this is going to be. Now, that Wildcat piston has got a 530 compression height, so it's normally down the hole quite a bit, but I've got this 3-inch, 353-thousandths long rod. Now, the stock rod is 3 inches, 303, or 308-thousandths. So, you know, this rod should be around 50-thousandths. 50-thousandths longer, but with the 530 compression height on this piston, it still drops it down the hole some. And the way it's going here, it's below deck. I can feel it a little bit now. That's good. How much below deck? Boy, that feels good. Man, this is great. It's 16 and a half, almost 17 thousandths below deck. That is great. Now I have a 12 thousandths thick shim gasket. I could use a head gasket I could use with that. And that would make me 27 thousandths on my quench, or, you know, squish, if you want to call it squish. But yeah, that would leave me 27 thousandths distance between the top of the piston and the bottom of the head. So that, with a billet rod, I think I feel comfortable with that. And this crankshaft is a little bit shorter stroke too. So yeah, I don't see any issues whatsoever with this build. And that's all I've got for today, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.